My mind just more naturally thinks in numbers. So I grew up in Southeast Iowa, and when I left the family farm, I wanted to be a full-time poker player. I very much from day one treated poker like a business. Instead of playing by gut feelings, I decided to play by mathematical odds. I would play up to 40 tables at once. Each table had 80 hands an hour, so over 3,000 hands an hour, a few million hands of poker a year. It helped prepare me for startups by just remaining process-oriented and understanding you need a proper sample size of data. You know, everyone says that 9 out of every 10 companies fail. So my mind translates that as I just have to start 10 companies.
Today, Clayton is working on his second tech company, Nebullam. The plan was to become the name brand for indoor farming equipment. They never intended to become an actual farm.
I never thought I would be a farmer, but I think jumping out of the plane and building the parachute on the way down is the best approach.
You just started your dream business. How much profit would you need to pay your basic living expenses, like rent and ramen? This is a show on the economics of entrepreneurship and founders turning their dreams into reality. This is Ramen Profitable.
I think naivety carries you a long way. When Danen and I started Nebullam, we saw that indoor farming was very antiquated, where you have a bunch of growing equipment that's all stacked on top of each other. It doesn't move, so you have to have these big aisleways. And then there's little to no software in the day-to-day, amounting to producing small amounts of food per square foot while requiring a lot of labor. That combination adds up to an average indoor farm takes 7 years to reach profitability, so that's why most go under. We thought we could come along and implement better, more scalable technology to help indoor farms become profitable faster. So here at Nebullam, we focused on making our growing equipment mobile. And that's because at the end of the day, you are paying to heat and cool all of your space, whether you're growing plants in it or not. When we started Nebullam, we thought we wanted to ultimately sell the growing equipment to new and expanding indoor farms, and then license the software that runs that equipment for the recurring revenue piece.
They needed to test and develop their growing equipment. So they temporarily sold the produce it grew to local restaurants and grocery stores to offset the cost of running the business.
We're growing at 2 to 5% month over month, really just proving this out. And then the pandemic hits. I remember going down to the farm and just sitting there because I didn't know what to do. With the governor announcing that all restaurants are going to close, we just lost at minimum 3/4 of our revenue. And a lot of what-if scenarios were just running through my mind. I kind of just had to slap myself out of it. We need to find a home for this food. We can't put lettuce on pause from growing, and we've got essentially 6 days before the next harvest.
They decided to try a subscription model, selling produce direct to customers on a recurring basis.
So we told ourselves we had to go and get 12 subscribers, and all of them had to be people we had no connections to. It started with rebuilding the website, which I'm the last person you want building a website. I'm a little colorblind as well. Apparently it was really ugly. But all we really need to do is grow lettuce, deliver lettuce. If the first version isn't pretty, that's okay. You just need to prove that functionality. And thankfully, it worked. We ended 2020 with 50 subscribers.
So here's what I'm thinking. If we take just our current demographic and we overlaid that in all 6 of those locations.
Right, see which one matches up the best.
Exactly,
yeah.
So we don't have to reinvent the wheel.
With our new business model, I see as very much as we're a data company sitting on top of a supply chain company, sitting on top of a vertical farm or an indoor farm. And that means every decision we make needs to be data-driven. So in my mind, data is the words to the story. And I've been just obsessed with it my entire life, which is numbers. To me, it's, you know, am I making progress on something?
A subscription-based business model lives and dies by its customer acquisition cost, or how much money it takes to get a new customer.
So before pivoting, our customer acquisition cost was an entirely different mathematical equation. We need to know who our subscribers are and why they actually buy from us.
They use their customers' data to identify trends that help identify potential new customers. Since they are a local farm, they take a local approach.
One of our most successful outlets for bringing new subscribers is offline, which I know is crazy in today's world, but that's door stickers. It's costing us 3 times more to pick up a subscriber online, and that's about $150 compared to picking up a subscriber through door stickers for about $50. We always want to be reducing that. So now we're making more and more data-driven decisions around customer acquisition costs.
If it costs $100 on average to bring in a new subscriber and they make $11 a week per subscription, they know it takes about 9 weeks per subscriber to recoup the cost, or about 2 months. Lowering that acquisition cost is key to scaling.
Now that this model is working and we're reaching a proper scale, natural next steps for us is to take what we've built here and cookie cutter it into another location. We're excited because this year we're going from essentially one location and 1,000 square feet of production to 2 locations and 3,000 square feet. So we started the year with 300 subscribers. By the end of the year of 2022, we want to be at 1,500 subscribers. Whether you like numbers or not, you have to know your numbers. At the end of the day, you need to understand that cash flow and when you can actually reach profitability. So I think anyone starting a business today or anyone excited about starting a company or scaling a company should understand their numbers.
Before the pivot, the plan was working. It was slow, but they were growing. Fast forward to after the pivot, Nebullam is growing 8 times faster than their old business model.
There's over 60 deliveries today among the Ames area. When we launch new locations, we'll have over 300 deliveries going out every single week. I think it's really important to set out trying to solve a problem you're passionate about. In our case, we think everyone deserves access to reliable and local food year round. And as we go after achieving that mission, our vision comes to life. And our vision is to replace the produce aisle.